Alright, Guardians, so we are here at Lady Efrideet's inventory, and she's got a couple things we want to look at. As I told you guys previously, the armor is going to be basically tier 12, so it's 98 to 100% on stats. So boots, these look to be about 100%, if not pretty much up there. You've got discipline and strength, but again, you're looking at the perks as well. So I mean, these are going to be fusion and rocket launcher, these are going to be shotgun and machine gun. Here you've got hand cannon and shotgun ammo. This one, you've got hand cannon and sniper rifle ammo in the chest, so this is probably the one I would go for. Unfortunately, it's not in discipline, so just depends on the stats and the gun combinations that you need. So those are all going to be good. Just look between your characters, between the Hunter, the Warlock, and the Titan. See which ones fit the stats you need. If you're missing a piece, just throw them in there, and you can go for that tier 12 build. But let's get to the important part of the guns and see if we've got any god rolls. First, we've got the Silver Dread. This is the machine gun, and we've got Rangefinder, so a nice boost to that range. Of course, he's always got terrible lighting. Got Field Scout, so you're going to actually be able to carry more ammo, which is not a bad thing. And you've got Perfect Balance, so a stable gun with a boost of range and extra ammo as just a pretty solid machine gun in the first place. Not too shabby, honestly. It could maybe be a little bit better if you had something with a little more stability over here, but the range boost for a little more range if you're ADS, which you're going to be with this thing anyway. Perfect Balance, and then you could go Quick Draw if you want it drawn extremely quickly, but I think Field Scout might benefit you more. Just have to see if that makes a difference on the heavy ammo pickups. You also got Accurized Ballistics if you want to drop a smidge of impact but get a more boost to range and stability. Pretty much the same between the two of these. So honestly, this is not too shabby. It should be pretty stable with this and one of the other two ballistics options. And then you've got Rangefinder for a boost out there for your range when you're ADS, and then a bonus here. Can't really ask for a whole lot more in a machine gun. Definitely one in PvP. Worthwhile for level 4, that's for sure. God roll, I'll have to look and see, but I think it's definitely up there. As for the Clever Dragon, looks like we're off to a good start. We've got Counterbalance, we've got Oil, we've got Small Bore, which unfortunately is going to lower that magazine size, but give you a boost to stability and range, which both are beneficial. Pair that with Counterbalance, the range and extra stability should be good. You can go lightweight, or you can go high caliber rounds for booster range. Get a little more stagger on that gun. Should be pretty nice. So I think this one could be a little better, but starting with Counterbalance is never a bad thing. Going with a boost to stability and range, you give up a little magazine size, but you seem to do that on everything with the Clever Dragon anyway, so may as well have a boost to both. And then high caliber rounds, you know, hit those bullets a little harder. Got the good old Iron Warrior sights, and then the Iron Range Scope. So if you're okay with higher stability but want a little more range, go with the Range Scope, a little extra target acquisition as well. So honestly, not too shabby. Counterbalance is going to control it pretty well. You've got a boost to stability here, got a boost to range here, and some high caliber rounds for some range. Could be a little better, I think, with a little more on the stability side of things, without giving up so much here on something like Small Bore. If you went Injection Mold, that might be nice. But in the grand scheme, I think you've got a pretty good option here. And of course, you're going to get primaries and heavies for infusion fodder. These can still drop in all the matches, so try and go for any and all these, of course, as possible. But in the grand scheme of things, tier 12 armor across the board for all your characters. I'm not looking at the other characters because they're all going to be very, very similar. Just depends on what perks you need. But the machine gun and the pulse rifle are pretty solid. Counterbalance here and rangefinder paired with stability on this one with perfect balance. You've got this one here paired with small bore for range and stability. Both going to be pretty good guns. May not be that epic tier, not quite god roll on either, I don't think, but they're definitely going to be solid, usable guns. So if you get to rank 4 and 5 and you don't have these before, they're definitely not going to be throwaways if you pick them up. So hope you guys enjoyed. You know the usual bounties. You get your iron support, 100 points there for assists, avenges, and defense. Iron arsenal, just points for different type of weapon kills. Iron light. Points for ability kills of all types. And then, of course, Iron Marathon, just completing matches. Whether completing them, you'll get 5 points. Winning, you get 10 points. So the more you win, the quicker it goes. Either way, pretty decent bounties. You get weapon, armor, and those are going to be of types that are not sold by Efrideet. So the armor will, of course, be class item, gauntlets, and helms. And then the weapons will be anything that is not these two. Sniper rifle, rocket launcher, you know, scout rifle, whatever it is. So you got some decent options. You do this between 3 characters, you're going to have a lot of options. It's going to be fun. You got Mayhem Clash Live, so you got a good one to do it in. So, hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, drop that like below. If you got any questions about builds or perks or anything like that, let me know as well. Mayhem should be a lot of fun, I think, for everybody. So, go out there and enjoy it. Have some fun this week. If you haven't got rank 5 from the previous Iron Banner for your book, this would be the week to do it. Fast matches, lots of kills, total mayhem. Just don't, you know, take anything too seriously this week and just have some fun. Enjoy the week. Talk to you guys soon. Have a good one.